Welcome to a new test and teardown video. This time it's something quite special. This one is a phase angle measuring device from a company called Baur. The type number is called VMG 50. And this is for mains frequency. And you plug in mains, and then you take it out to your load at the back. You can use all sorts of external probes or internal amp and volt measuring as well. It says here internal or external sensors, and then you can connect voltage, current, and then you can measure the angle. And you can turn this to zero the angle, as far as I can understand. It is a little bit complicated to figure all this out, so this is why they added more or less a full operating instructions here on the side of the unit. Look at that. All that kind of stuff you need to read and understand, then you should be able to figure this out. And it's even here is on the back. They also explain the circuits for internal or external sensors. So here is our input. So this will be your internal sensor configuration, where it measures voltage and current. Or you can use the external connectors here and also at the front. And then you should be ready to go. As far as I can see, there isn't any fuse to the output that goes here. But this fuse is only to its own internal use. Could have been smart to have a fuse here when you're playing around with all sorts of test stuff. So that is a little detail that I was missing. There's actually also a label here at the bottom that again says this one is from Austria, and also say the type number VMG50. It was very, very easy for me to Google manuals and all that kind of stuff, and I could see the manual is from 1988. So it is that old. Oh, I don't need that. Ha ha. That is nice. I'm always using my reel of solder. But that is a lot smarter, isn't it? How about we see if it works? Maybe I should turn off the light. And then we'll crank on mains power and we'll monitor the current is... Well, the power usage is only 9 watts. That is not a lot. Oi! Look at that! Hey, yay! So we got a nice ring. How beautiful is that? And then you go internal. Or external. Is it supposed to be like that? I thought we would have a line. And then the line would be, well... So that is definitely how it looks. I'll go and find something to stick in the connector. So I'm trying to figure out how this works. So when I crank this up to voltage internal, you see this little dot? Then you adjust this little black zero where this little dot goes, right? And then you crank to current, and then you see the phase difference. What I have now is I've got my isolation transformer for my scope is now connected and it's powered on. So this is the idle power you see of my isolation transformer. So now I turn off my isolation transformer. There is no current usage, so there is no dot at all, right? So now I turn on the isolation transformer. Oops, hold this again. Now I try and hit the power on switch on my scope. Is there any kind of a difference? I didn't see that. The scope is booting up at the moment. Maybe I should find something with a more crazy phase angle. And also, you're not revealing any kind of big phase difference when I'm going through an isolation transformer with a lot of inductance. So, I mean, I don't see anything here. Let's try and, while we hold this, I don't know if I can turn this off right now. It's still booting up. Okay, so it is almost done booting up. Yes. Let's try and turn it off. And then we're looking real careful. Yes, it moved a little bit, a tiny little millimeter. That was all we saw. So I guess this unit works, but it's not a lot to see here. I don't have stuff with a real bad phase angle. Well, I shouldn't have, because it's not legal to have a huge phase angle. But it's really beautiful, this meter with this circle and all that. So now we are inside this absolutely beautiful instrument here. Look at that, how beautiful it is. Everything is in perfect order. I love it. So look at the diodes. And that's of course the diodes they mention on the rear side. But look, the isolation between those two aren't really that fantastic. I hope that's not a high voltage. And then there's a little trimmer here. And look at that switch. That is really something that can handle a lot of current. But look at those thin wires that goes here. It's not like that, isn't it? And then that will be the entire circuit. That is just a beautiful differential amplifier, phase amplifier for phase detector, right? And then Netzteil, that is a power supply, right? That is beautiful. So that is high voltage stuff. And even says the colors. Schwarz, grau, grün, gelb und rosa, orange, rot und so weiter. Yeah, this is super schön. I love it. Oh, you gotta see this. What have we got up here? 6 bulbs in series. I totally want to power this up now and see. When are they lit? Hang on a second. I will try this. So now the meter is powered up again. Let's look at those bulbs. So in all those settings, we see nothing, right? But haha. So that is voltage and that is current. And I think that what they're doing here is they're disconnecting the current measurement on the output and then generating a tiny little load. So you will see this little zero. This is actually the load, but since it's resistors, this is of course in perfect zero phase. So if you also put on a load in load mode, that is a resistor, you're going to have a dot at exactly 0 degrees. You see, that is how it works. That is beautiful. Those bulbs are just absolutely amazing. course they're glowing this week, so they're going to last forever. That is the idea. Ooh, I'm touching stuff here. I should definitely not touch anything with my fingers here, but there were no voltage on here. Yeah, yeah, yeah. It could be dangerous. I better turn it off like that. And let's turn on the light again. But this is absolutely amazing how beautiful that layout is. A lot of people could learn something from this. The order and everything with the lines and writing, whatever it is. And I totally love it. And also the fact that they're just using all the space there is. It's not compact or any, like, all over on top of each other, all those parts, like you see a lot of designs where every little millimeter they're hunting it down so they can make it as small as possible. That is definitely not the case here. Yeah. That is a wonderful unit. Is this all the way in here? And a beautiful, beautiful tube. Yeah, I don't have so much more to say about this, actually. So, I better go on a little vacation here. So you can enjoy this. So, maybe we'll see you again tomorrow. Bye-bye.